Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I'm Dr. Hina Khan and today we're going to discuss the trophic as well as the peripheral causes towards the corneal ulcerations. Ulceration is basically a word used for a breach in the epithelium of any structure, and over here we are discussing the corneal epithelium in detail. We have already gone through the different miscellaneous causes, that is basically we have the infective causes towards the development of the corneal ulcerations. Mainly, we have the bacterial causes, the viral, as well as the protozoal causes towards the development of corneal ulcerations. When we are discussing the corneal ulcerations, we must know that besides the infections, a lot of degenerations can even result in corneal ulcerations. So over here, we have the trophic kind of corneal ulcerations. Trophic is a word basically that is focusing on the fact that it's basically a degenerative cause towards the development of corneal ulceration. So we'd be discussing the major clinical features over here and what are the different sorts of treatment modalities that are present that can basically relate and help in healing of these kind of trophic ulcerations in these individuals. Then finally, we'd be dealing with the neurotrophic keratopathies. So there are the congenital causes. We have the acquired classifications towards the development of neurotrophic keratopathies. So when we say the acquired conditions, we basically mean any trauma, any neoplasms that can pressurize the Gasserian ganglion or even the infections that can occur at the Gasserian ganglion. That is basically going to result in the neurotrophic kind of keratopathies that are discussed over here. So we'd be going through briefly the clinical features, the treatment modalities that are related to these neurotrophic kind of keratopathies. We'd be discussing the exposure keratopathy in detail over here. So different factors, for example, proptosis, it can be any physiological leg ophthalmos or any causes that are finally giving way, for example, the Bell's palsy that is resulting in the improper closure of the eyelid and finally resulting in the exposure keratitis in these individuals. Obviously, this kind of exposure keratitis and can finally result in a decrease in the visual acuity as well as the development of ulcerations in the individuals. Then we'd be discussing the peripheral ulcerative keratopathy. So this is a wholly different discussion when we discuss what are the different causes that can result in the peripheral ulcerations in the cornea. So we'd be discussing their causative, the predisposing factors, and what are the management guidelines towards the healing of the peripheral ulcerative keratopathies over here. We'd be summarizing briefly the marginal keratolysis, and then finally we'd be giving you the details of Mooren's ulcers, which is also known as a rodent ulceration. So we'd be discussing the clinical features over here and finally the treatment guidelines that are related to Mooren's ulcerations. Then we have another condition which is known as rosacea keratitis, which is usually associated with acne rosacea. Often you would see these patients with a rash which is basically prominent on the nasal bridge as well as a malar rash, and you should know how to diagnose and obviously treat these patients that are suffering from rosacea keratitis. So we have thousands of medical lectures out there on our website, so do watch these lectures. Thanks for watching sqadia.com and get access to watch the complete lecture.